I'm going to add a ring. Make this just a little bit thinner. And I want to change the positioning to give it some exact positioning and an exact size. To do that, I'm going up to Format, Position and Size. And it's going to position to this upper left corner. I'm going to make this 5 inches. And we're going to change this one to 1 inch in. We can see our width and our height are 2 inches. Clicking OK. Let's give this one the color of orange. Now I'm going to make a copy of that using Control C, Control V, and I'm going to use my right arrow to move it a little to the side. We're going to make this one red with a red line. So I also want to give these some names. So I'm going to right click on the orange ring, give this the name orange ring. I'm going to click on the red ring, give this a name red ring. Clicking OK. I want to make it look like these rings are linked to one another. To do that, I'm going to add another ring, this block arc. I'm going to change the color to be red with the red line, just like our red ring. The next thing I want to do is give this a name. We'll call this red arc. We want this to have the same dimensions as our red ring with the same position. Let's take a look at what we have here. Position is 2.02. We're just going to change that to 2 to make it easier to remember, by 5. Position X is 2, position Y is 5, and a width and height of 2. So let's do the same with our arc. 2, 5, 2, and 2. Clicking OK. We see that we have the right positioning and size, but we need to reposition our extra handle. To help us out with that, I'm going to increase the size a little bit. Move the handle in. Let's zoom back out. And my problem is my red ring is in front of the orange already. So let's bring the orange ring in front. And here we see that it's in front of the red ring, but not our red arc. And when I click on this, we can see down here we gave it a name. Our red arc is selected. Clicking down below, the red ring is selected. Our orange ring is selected. Now, to make our arc stand out a little more, I'm going to make it green. Now we want to make our arc go over the bottom, so our link is at the bottom and top instead of the top and the bottom. I'm going to go to Format, Position and Size, and this time I'm going to the Rotation. Now it's telling us this is 0 degrees. We want to make this 180 degree change. So we want to come right to the other side. When I click OK, we see that our arc has moved down to the bottom. And now I want to change this back to red with red line. And we see the top and the bottom are reversed. One last thing I want to mention is we can use our tab key to switch selection between shapes. Right now, we're on the red arc. If I hit tab, it takes me up to the cube. Because we didn't give this a name, it's only telling us a shape is selected. I'm going to hold down shift and tab takes us back to the red arc. If I hit Shift and Tab again, it takes me to the orange ring. Shift and Tab again takes me back to the red ring.